In the first section, there was no battle, and probably there will be no battle in the second section, because many statements that were made by the previous lecturer, I agree with them entirely. Just for us, endoscopic removal and surgical removal is a battle between East and West, because East is for ASD and they are not using TM as method, and West is for TM. They do not recognize ASD and is not recognizing it, going to recognize it in the near future. There were a lot of things demonstrated. I will show the guideline, NCCN guideline, that doesn't mention endoscopic removal in case of a choice method for leiocarcinomas. In the rectum ESMAS guideline, it says nothing about endoscopic removal of leiocarcinomas in the rectum. And the European recommendations of 2016, when we have seen and read them, we were glad, because endoscopic dissection and endoscopic resection were adopted as a choice method for carcinomas, and ASD could use up to 20 centimeters. Then endoscopic dissection, the submucous layer, if it is larger. At the end of the guidelines, there was a reference. It is quite vague. They say that endoscopic dissection of submucous layer is technically difficult, and probably in the Western countries, so far it is not possible because there is no sufficient experience. And endoscopic resection is a choice method for carcinomas less than 20 millimeters. And so that is a golden standard for removal early of early carcinomas in the rectum. As to the battle between East and West, this is the opinion of the Japanese guideline. They think that inside a consoloma, a T1 with one invasion should be applied to endoscopic dissection in submucous and endoscopic resection and block. If that is a radical resection, that will be follow up. If it is non-radical resection, vertically and horizontally in the margin, that is surgical treatment. And what is a radical or non-radical criteria of radicality? Differentiation of the tumor, deepness of invasion into submucous layer. And I would not agree that morphologists cannot assess their specimens after dissection, because they don't have the entire submucous layer with the muscles. They have tumor budding, the last tumor cells in specimen. Tumor budding G1 is endoscopic radically removed resection, and the lack of lymphovascular invasion, which is prognostically preparing us for surgical treatment with lymph dissection. How can we remove the tumors in the rectum? We can use a transnasal microsurgery and endoscopically using several means, polytechnic resection of the mucous fragmentary, piecemeal resection and dissection in the submucous layer. Why from snare resection, we are not using it, and we are not using that part of that resection. In case of tumors less than 20 millimeters, we can remove it by unblock horizontally. As to the vertical margin, it is not easy to predict, because you cannot see that low. You put a snare and remove submucous layer blindly, and probably you might get less than 1,000 micron of submucous layer, the vertical border. That is a very high percentage. As for piecemeal removal, I think piecemeal removal of carcinomas in the gut related to jurisprudence, because that is R1 resection. Resection that dooms a patient, even in case of a possibility of radical removal, to surgical treatment, because that is R1 or RX, because the margins of coagulation edge would not be make it possible to determine the invasion depth. That's just a burn. Why East and West? Why this trend? Why is they separated? East is always for unblocked resection, and so that to extend the specimen without false positive horizontal margins. The West often allows a piecemeal resection that results in R1 resection. I think if we remove such a carcinoma in Brussels, in the Netherlands, or in Germany, in this situation, AMR would be piecemeal resection. It will not be put into a snare. What would they do in the West, of course, at TM? As to the relapses, the recurrences after transanal resection, that is nonsense for me because it seems to me that surgically you take everything out, but still they occur and they account for 8%. That is a significant amount of relapses, and they are related not only with the size of the tumor but also with its distance from anorectal line, from the serrated line, and recurrences might be different. The situation, the patient from 2012 had surgery. There was endoscopy, the piecemeal resection, and transanal section. And there was a malignant, a benign tubular adenoma, and she had anterior resection, and there was a relapse. You see, anastomosis here. What should we do in this situation? What recurrences should occur after surgical treatment? As to the borders, it can clearly you can clearly see the border of the tumor. You can get such a picture only endoscopically. You will see it in white line, but it is very difficult to find the border, and hence the local recurrences along the horizontal border. As to the limitations of the method, if we take circular, subcircular tumors, there are no limits to dissection. That these are more complicated patients because they are doomed to peridark bulging or balloon dilation. In transanal methods, that is not always the case. 2 years ago, Evgeny Gennadyevich showed wonderful anastomosis when he puts them transanally. In case of extended tumors, that is just pleasant to see even if the stricture formed, it is short, and it is easy to combat it, and there is a shorter period so that the patient would be left for follow-up. Propagation for anal canal, for dissection, that is not a problem. As far as I know, in case of transanal dissections, the distance from the serrated line is 4 centimeters, and these 4 centimeters are a blind zone for you. For us, there is no problem if it propagates from the rectum to sigmoid. The procedure of the surgery doesn't change. As to scar changes, yes, we should make a microsurgical operation because there is no rear, there might be a perforation. If the method is well developed and transanal dissections are made at the center, in order to do better for the patient, you have to use a microsurgical intervention. We have read one article concerning cost efficiency. I have come back from Korea not long ago, and they not only made that analysis, their dissection was not covered from the insurance policy. And 2 years ago, they included dissection, and now really dissection is covered by the insurance policy totally, and it is cheaper than transanal method. Why dissection was cheaper and TM shorter? That is the general anesthesia, because 1 day before it, they kept the patient for another day, and there were a lot of laboratory analysis. That's why TM was more expensive. As to complications, I won't discuss the perforations and bleedings. These are complications after both methods, no difference. But as to low-invasive intervention, there is a whole shuttle in the rectum. Of course, traumatization might occur, and we are speaking about mini-invasive method. So these low-pressure sphincter to 6 months, which is recovered half a year. If the patient looks calmly, it would not be a problem if it were not for mini-invasive procedures. As to peritoneal perforations, perforations to peritoneum after TM are recorded from 9% bleeding up to 10%. As to getting to the abdominal cavity, there are such situations in case of endoscopy dissection and submucous lay that is really the case for both methods. Our perforations are like that. They are not quite big, and they can be covered by endoscopic clips, and we not always work with them. Sometimes we have a perforation, then we complete the section, and then we are clipping the perforations. That is not a major problem. We never had such a problem. And we're working the rectum, where the entrance to mesorectum or to abdominal cavity is not problematic. As to endoscopic dissection and surgical removal, as to the yeast, prior to implementation of the unblocked dissection in submucous layer at the Tokyo Center, up to 20% of all rectal tumors were removed. Early rectal tumors were removed by surgical method. After implementation, that was only 1%, so they have long been using that method.
Moreover, the dissection, the number of dissections has been growing, and here is esophageal cancer, early esophageal cancer, rectal culture, intestinal, gastric one. So is the progressive growth here. Why do we love this methodology? Why is it wide, well controlled? You can see this navy color of the submucous layer. We can see where we digress from the muscle. We can get as much as we want. Well-controlled vessels, if there are complications, we can fully control the situation. Recently, we had a patient, 38 years of age, more than 10 centimeters a tumor going from the serrated line. So there should be extirpation of the rectum because there is no dissection. 38 years as to malignant tumor, actually, that would be cruel. That's post of defect. I'll show how it looks like. This is this serrated line. Actually, after half a year, she'll be able to somehow get reconciled with her rectum. Actual problems when you remove such tumors, they're big, so there are stenosis and strictures in 60 to 70 cases when half the circumference is resected, and much higher in full resection. To correct it, we need up to 6 months. But these strictures, at least that's half a year's seances of Beijing, and as to your anastomosis, it's way too long, nonetheless. And our results are quite modest. We had 84 endoscopic dissections in the rectum. Most of them were performed on the early malignant tumors. We had one conversion of axis when we were removing estrogenic endometriosis, and one resection as to the depth of invasion. There were 4 cases. There was not a single resection along the horizontal layer after the resection, and we had 3 post-op bleedings and 7 strictures. We removed them endoscopically. Conclusions. TAM is the method of choice at relapsing tumor. It does have any concurrence when it comes to radical surgeries. We heard about the cases when patients are not curable otherwise, so we can do that. But when it's malignant and early malignant, when it's benign tumors and early malignant tumors, there could be more lapses and complications if we do those surgeries. Thank you. Thank you very much for very interesting presentation. It's like the actual competition between East and West. We are in Russia here, and we have got several clinics like that in St. Petersburg already. Both techniques are well mastered here as well. In Vladivostok, also, they have got such clinics. And in Yaroslav, so this methodology, this technique, I mean, submucous dissection and transanal microsurgery, it has been covering many regions of our country. As regards the rectum, it seems to me altogether that as yet our practice shows that from our perspective, we don't have comparative trials which could bring us evidence, but it was not the competition between East and West, but the competition between endoscopy specialists and surgeons. And we decided that for endoscopy specialists, it would be well too good just to give them this rectum. So we say, okay, do it in the segmented gut. And actually, it's only right regions of submucous dissections of the segmentum. That's what they do, only on the segmented gut. And well, on the sigmoid only. I can't wait when the new methods will be broadly propagated. We need new equipment. Of course, that will impact the cost of the surgery because there is a special suturing device for suturing via colonoscope of the duodenum. It's very expensive, but that way that will remove all the challenges and problems because you are quite right. It's no problem when there is this opening in the rectum. You can use the clip on that. Another thing, when it's in the right regimens of the duodenum, and clip is not so ideal, mindful of the accuracy and thinness of the wall of the right regions of the duodenum. But alongside with that, I'm very glad that you have been accumulating experience along those lines in transanal microsurgery. If you discuss it with your chief wardens, with your bosses, if you're ready and willing to join up with our clinical trial, which started already, it would be a win-win situation for all. It will be a multi-site clinical trial, and then the rating of it will, I mean, it will be ranked much higher. So talk to your bosses about it. Thank you. It was a very interesting presentation.